Here with our men's basketball weekly update with head coach TJ Otzelberger. Let's recap last week. You got the win in the rivalry game against South Dakota. Really made it close down the stretch, back and forth. But a few more plays made by your team and got a big W to win a regular season championship.
I was really pleased with our defensive focus, especially in that first half. We, you know, had a 10-point lead going into halftime. Our guys were they're focused. We rebounded well. We finished plays well, and I think that led us to having some opportunities on the offensive side of the ball. And late in the game, they were able to get some momentum and take the lead. And really pleased with our guys, the way they stepped up, showed a lot of grit, resolve, character late in that game to make big plays on both sides of the floor and come out with a victory.
Is it fair to say that winning a regular season might actually be, in some respects, tougher to win than a tournament championship?
Yeah, I think, you know, it's a measure over 14 games as opposed to three. So, I mean, you're it's over a bigger body of work. You know, you've got to be at your best every night. There's a lot of really good teams in our league, and you've got to go on the road and play in tough environments. You're sick, you're tired, you're sore, schoolwork, all these things come into play. And I think, you know, there probably are more challenges when it comes down to a regular season championship than when it comes down to three games in 3 or 4 days.
It's definitely a focus every night. You had that on Saturday. You had one more game against Fort Wayne. Got a big lead in that one. They came back, similar to the home game you had against them a month ago, but a 97-90 win. Mike Dom, 8 more three-pointers. He's at 18 in the 2 games of the last 2 years. An impressive performance to get a win out there.
Yeah, it's Fort Wayne's a good team. They're playing well right now. And to come out the way we did, I was really happy with our guys. And then, you know, we got some separation there in that second half. And similar story, they fought back, cut it to 2, I believe, and then our guys kind of dug in and got the stops and finished plays we needed to. So, you know, it was their senior night, so it's an emotional night. They had a great crowd, and it meant a lot to me that our guys went in there, and even though we weren't playing for necessarily spot in the standings, we're playing for our team, ourselves, for our Jackrabbits, for our fans, community. We wanted to be at our best, and our guys did a great job of coming out and doing that.
It's kind of been the story all year long where teams have come back or you face adversity or whatever it might be, but your squad has been calm and collected and fought through that, and you got to feel good about that going into the Summer League tournament this week.
As a coach, you want to study the why and understand what's happened in some of those games that we've put ourselves in those challenging spots, but also understand what have we done to come out of those situations and where have we showed character and that resolve. And I think we'd like to do a better job of being more intentional on both sides of the ball when we do have a lead. But, you know, we're a team that plays really loose and aggressively. And sometimes when you get up, you don't want to take that aggressiveness away on either side of the ball. So, but we do need to be intentional. We do need to do the best job we can of protecting leads and not putting ourselves. We're going from leading to chasing in such a short period of time. But still like our guys' confidence and poise down the stretch. Doing what we need to do to come out with victories.
13-1 in league play, as you alluded to earlier. 25-6 overall. How would you grade out the season? You pretty pleased with how things went?
I am, and it's not always the wins and losses where you want to, as a coach, where you want to grade your team out. You want to see your team continue to get better. You want to see them play for each other. You want to see them be at their best as you move forward. And I think we can confidently say all those things about our group, that we've gotten better as the year's gone on, that we're definitely a group that's together, and that we're playing our best basketball. And I feel like we still have our best basketball in front of us. And hopefully that can be something that when we come out Saturday night, that can be on display. I think this team's got a lot of potential. We've got a lot of talented players. They enjoy being together and playing together. And if our focus is right, we can take our game to the next level. And that's my hope as we enter our game Saturday night.
It's that time of year, March Madness. Earned the #1 seed against Western Illinois. As you said, Saturday night, 6 o'clock. Big game against a team, obviously, you played twice this season. Great environment down in Sioux Falls as well, and it should be a good game.
Yeah, we're really enthusiastic to get back down to the Denny. And you come out, you see that sea of yellow and blue, and it's very humbling. We have such passionate fans. We're so fortunate and thankful to them for supporting us the way they do. It gives us that much more energy to play at our best. So really excited. This time of the year is a fun time of the year. Thrilled to be able to go down there and have such great fans and, you know, be at our best come Saturday night.
Last year it was kind of a grind and obviously a lot of dramatics to get to that tournament or title. And How do you use any of that last year, or is it treat this year different, or how do you approach this year?
I think in both years, we're in the spot where we're playing pretty well at the end of the year, and we need to come out and worry about being the best version of ourselves. So last year as the four seed, one thing that we proved is that anybody can win on any given night, and you've got to be at your best. And that certainly holds true whether you're the one seed, the eighth seed, or anywhere in between. So it's a new season. We need to hit reboot. It doesn't change it. We need to play our best basketball and play together. All that changes is that those things that have happened up to this point have prepared us for this moment, and these games and these opportunities are starting with Saturday night. But other than that, it's a totally new season.